Have you ever generated images using edges or generated them using segmentation mask or depth maps? Using ControlNet, you can accomplish all this and even more. Hey there, welcome to LearnOpenCV. In this video, we will learn about ControlNet and check out various ways to use it. ControlNet is a stable diffusion-based neural network that allows us to control the generated image by conditioning both the prompts and the images through various techniques like canny edge, huff lines, segmentation map, depth, and more. For techniques like canny edge, we input an RGB image. An intermediate processor then extracts the canny edges from the image and uses that to guide the image generation. There is a ControlNet model for every image conditioning technique. When no text prompt is given, a default text prompt, that is, a high-quality, detailed, and professional image, is used. An automatic image captioning model, like Blip, can be used over the default generations to create automatic prompts. This prompt can then be used to generate images, creating a SOTA pipeline for fully automatic conditional image generation. Various techniques that ControlNet include are human scribbles, HED boundary map, human pose, and normal map. Let's deploy ControlNet on Gradio and try out the ControlNet canny model. Learn more about AI art generation in our course, Mastering Generative AI for Art, only on OpenCV University. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, LearnOpenCV. We'll be using NVIDIA A100 GPU, but you can also run this model on a T4 GPU. Let's start by cloning the ControlNet GitHub repository and install the required libraries. If you're running on Colab, you'll need to restart the runtime. Next, we'll download the ControlNet canny model. We have given links to other models as well. If you wish to download and use them, simply uncomment those lines. Now, if we directly launch the Gradio app, it will only give us a local URL. Since we are running on Google Colab, we won't be able to open the link. This code block will edit all the Python scripts and add the share equal to true argument. Finally, we will launch the Gradio app. This is the Gradio UI. Drop the image in the input image component. We are using the image of a swallow. Let's make this bird a yellow crested warbler. So our text prompt is going to be yellow crested warbler detailed. Before hitting run, let's tweak some advanced options. Under advanced options, we can choose the number of image generations. Let's go with 2. We can also choose the output image resolution and the control strength. Let's increase the number of steps because that generally gives us good results. Now let's hit run. The intermediate preprocessor will create the canny edge of the input image. These are the ControlNet outputs. ControlNet is created using 2 pre-trained copies of a large image diffusion model. One of these copies is trainable and the other's weights are frozen. This is what the ControlNet model looks like. The trainable copy of the model is trained with the conditioning vector C. This gives ControlNet the power to control the overall behavior of the neural network, which gives us more control during inference. Refer to our blog post to understand the inner workings of ControlNet models. Link in description. So, that's all about ControlNet. If you like this video, why don't you check out InstructPix2Pix, where you can edit images by passing text prompts. Or check out other videos in the AI Art Generation playlist. Do comment on what you would like to see next, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Until next time.